worry, Lyle. Next one's yours. Come on, let's go tag him. Pick him up on the way back.
Get out!
Shh, come here. Look. See?
Oh, yeah.
Be careful. Safety's off.
Hey, wait a minute. I don't think I'm ready.
Come on, come on. Just remember what I told you. Be all right. Come on.
Target practice is one thing. But
come on, he's not gonna be there all day. Just shoot.
I don't think I can do it.
Oh, Lyle, what's the matter? Don't you let him get away.
Just couldn't do it. Maybe next time I'll be okay.
Glad to see you could make it.
Yeah, well, look, I've been thinking, Rich. I really don't want to go through with this. I mean, I don't even know why I came this far.
Come on, Lyle. Hunting's the best sport in the world.
Yeah, sure. Sure. For the hunter. But what about the animal?
Who cares how the animal feels? I brought you up here to give you a lesson in hunting, not philosophy.
Maybe the animal cares. You ever think about that?
Believe me, Lyle, they don't understand.
Yeah, well, I bet they understand one thing. Fear. Fear of pain and fear of death. What's so funny?
Be real. The world's made out of two classes. The hunters and the hunted. Let's just be glad you and I are the hunters.
You know what you've been saying? You've been saying that the hunted have no chance at all.
Now, will you get off my back?
What do you mean, get off your back? I mean, get off my back! You know why you hunt, huh? Rich, you know why you hunt? Just to put another head on your wall. That's all.
The only reason I hunt is to eat, and if you don't eat up here, you don't survive.
But you don't have to hunt to eat.
Listen, man, I don't have to put up with this. I'm going to hunt, and I'm going to enjoy myself. If you don't like it, you don't have to come along.
Okay, great.
Okay, then you just run along, you chase your butterflies, and I'll meet you back in the car Sunday morning. How's that?
Okay.
Okay, then we'll see who's the worst for wear.
Yeah, we'll see. Mm-hmm.
I really appreciate you helping me out.
Mighty nice 30-06 you got here.
I see you have a fine eye for rifles.
Well, it's not too often I find such a fine weapon in the hands of such an incompetent trailsman.
What'd you expect to find up here, a tiger?
No, an elephant.
Pretty cocky, huh? Well, you hungry?
Yeah, starved.
Help yourself.
Thanks, don't mind if I do.
Take your fill. I've already eaten.
Thanks. My name's Richard Baker. What's yours?
Williams.
Place seems pretty secluded. Lived around here long?
Oh, I've had this place for years. Needed someplace quiet where I could get away and do some serious thinking.
Well, about what?
Nothing that would concern you. So, you like hunting, do you?
Yeah, it's my favorite sport.
To you, it's a sport. To me, it's my life.
Well, what do you mean by that?
You see, I hunt for a living.
Really?
Well, that is, I did until I became bored with it.
Bored with hunting?
Yes, with hunting.
Tell me, how does one get bored with hunting?
Quite easily. When it's no longer fascinating. When it becomes too easy. When you always get your quarry. There's no greater bore than perfection.
That's quite a boast.
That's no boast. It's a mathematical certainty. The animal has nothing but its legs and its instinct. Instinct is no match for reason. I'm sure you'll agree with that, Baker.
Sure. I mean, no animal can reason, but I remember it was last year, I guess it was.
Well, when you've hunted for over 30 years, as I have, you'll begin to feel the same way.
Maybe.
Maybe? What the hell do you mean, maybe? You don't know a damn thing about hunting, do you? What do you think is so fascinating about the hunt, anyway? I'll tell you. It's because it's your mind against the animal. You see, the hunt keeps you constantly thinking, anticipating the next move of your prey, outwitting the animal in its own environment. This is the excitement of the chase. But tell me, Baker, what happens when it's no longer fascinating? When it becomes too easy?
I guess you look for a more worthy prey.
And what are the attributes of a more worthy prey? You haven't answered my question.
I don't think anybody can answer that question but you.
Sit down! Sit down! What are the attributes of an ideal quarry? It's obvious. must have courage, cunning, and above all, it must be able to reason.
No animal can reason.
Ah, but there's one that can.
You can't be serious.
Why shouldn't I be serious? I'm speaking about hunting.
Hunting?
Exactly. Just think of it. The battle of the wits, the excitement, the chase.
It's murder.
Baker, life is for the strong, to be lived by the strong. The weak of the world were put here to give the strong pleasure. If I'm strong, why shouldn't I use my gift?
But you're talking about men.
Exactly. They can reason, therefore they are dangerous.
Well, look, Mr. Weeks, I'm not trying to argue with you. I want you to understand that.
Well, but if you refuse to see the truth, then there's no point in going on. I suggest you get some sleep and rebuild your strength. I imagine you want to resume your hunt in the morning.
That's why I came up here.
And that's why I came up here. Good night, Baker.
Thank you again for helping me out. Really appreciate it.
No trouble.
Which way back to the trail?
There, right, about a quarter of a mile. Can't miss it.
Thanks again.
Good hunting.
Thank you.
disappointed me, Baker.
Thank you.